science, technology, engineering, math. This next guest excels in at least two of these, and probably all four.
Space. Nobody knows how to get there better than the people at the Jet Propulsion Laboratory in Pasadena, California. Here, scientists work on the coolest stuff in the universe. They've built rockets. They've built robots. They've built a space phone that calls Santa. Just kidding. They don't have a space phone that calls Santa. I know because I asked. But one thing they did build is the Mars rover Curiosity. Curiosity, about the size of a car, not only investigates Martian climate and geology, it also sometimes takes selfies. Looking good, Curiosity. Work it, work it. And back on Earth, over 33 million miles away, space roboticist Vandi Verma drives the rover right from her desk at JPL.
So I'm Vandi Verma, and I drive rovers on Mars.
Well, guess what? I have my license on me. Do you think I could try out driving the rover?
Well, it might take just a little bit more training than that.
Vandi also operates Curiosity's robotic arm, which it uses to take samples. To drive the rover, Vandi gives it a set of instructions to follow that the robot then carries out. Like if you gave a car a list of directions ahead of time and then it drove itself.
Let's get to driving 101. What does it take to drive the rover in the first place?
In order to drive the rover, the first thing we do is we get images from Mars.
These are actual images from Mars?
Yes, these are actual images from Mars. And a lot of our tools process these images automatically and create a 3D terrain mesh that allows us to put the rover in that terrain.
The 3D images help Vandi avoid dangerous terrain and create the best path for the rover to take.
We can't hit the brakes. The rover's gonna do the entire drive, so we have to think of everything that could go wrong ahead of time.
So the problem solving begins and you're thinking 20 steps ahead so that the rover knows what to do.
When you're looking at something, it's really hard to tell what the size might be or if there's a ridge or a cliff or a crevasse there. So you want to look at it in 3D.
This is what these glasses are for, right?
That's exactly right. And then you put them on. We can see that there are rocks.
Look how much
it pops out, and you can see that behind this ridge, there's another ridge, and there's actually a gap here.
I see it. This is wild. I'm looking at the Mars rover right now, traveling on this really rugged terrain.
You can see this is just dotted with locations where we've done sampling and study.
How long did it take for the rover to come from this point to this point?
So we landed on August 5th, 2012, and we've covered about 20 kilometers, which is about 12 miles.
I can't imagine driving that distance here on Earth and it taking that long.
Unless every step of the way, there was something that you had never seen before and you wanted to stop and check it out.
Vandi, what is the rover actually searching for?
So Curiosity's goal is to find if Mars was ever a habitable place. It's like a Swiss Army knife of rovers. We've got so many instruments and different data that we can collect with them.
Wow. Vandi, thank you so much for this experience. I mean, it's incredible.
It was a pleasure to have you here.